This is a quick demonstration of recent enhancements in our Genome Data Viewer, including several track graph settings and the ability to apply settings to all tracks in a composite track hub. Even though today's examples use the Genome Data Viewer, these enhancements also apply to other NCBI resources that incorporate the Sequence Viewer, such as SNP and Gene. Starting on the GDV homepage, use the Browse Genome button to go into the current human assembly, GRCH38. Then in the Tracks menu, use Configure Track Hubs and connect to the Blueprint Epigenomics Hub, which you see is a composite track. I've already selected a few of the bigwig tracks, but notice that you can adjust some track settings right here in this Hub Configuration menu, including an option to apply these settings to the entire group. I'll hit Configure, and these tracks load in the viewer. I used the Search widget to go to the region of the RCC1 gene, mostly just to zoom in a bit. And let's say you want a cleaner view of the peaks in this middle track, which now has a maximum value of 4.3 in the default linear scale. Click on the track name, or you can also just hover on the track name, then click on the gear icon in the tooltip menu that appears. I'll change to a line graph and set the value range from 1 to 4 for this linear scale. Notice that this menu includes the option to apply these settings to the entire blueprint group. We even indicate where the data have been clipped in the newly set range. Note the red region. To show a few more features, I'll go back to the Configure Track Hubs menu to connect to a different hub and select two tracks that display as a merged track. Here's that track, which combines data for both splice donor and splice acceptor predictions in green and red, respectively. But you can now separate them into individual tracks by choosing the stacked view. You can also change the color scheme in what we call a subtrack. If I click on the green side, the menu opens with that track selected. But you can change the color and other settings for both tracks in this menu. You can also hide one of the tracks. To recover that subtrack, go back into the menu, select the hidden subtrack, and uncheck Hide Subtrack. That's it for this demonstration. You can review these new features in a post to our blog, NCBI Insights. And as always, we'd love to have your feedback and questions. Feedback is right here at the bottom of the page. And for questions, please use our support center.